This is a vintage Black & Decker all-in-one deluxe automatic bread maker, and I found it at a Goodwill for $4.99, but then it was priced 50 off, so I paid $2.50 plus tax. Really good price. It's relatively good shape, doesn't have a lot of scratches, and it's complete. It has the mixing paddle, which it's important. That part alone is about 10 bucks on eBay if you have this missing. It's relatively clean. It doesn't look like used a lot. It's vintage. I think it comes from the year 2000. And it's got the few options to choose from. Now, if you test a bread maker, as soon as you hit the start button, it will start, the motor will start spinning. The mixing paddle will be working. In this machine, according to instruction found online, if you use the rapid bake, the paddle starts in 5 minutes after warming up at the inside a little bit. If you use the regular basic bread, it will need 15 minutes before starting to spin. And if you use the whole grain bread, one of these options, then it needs 25 minutes before it starts to spin. So it's good to know if you test one of these. If it looks like this, or it's a Black & Decker, the best option is use the rapid bake, wait 5 minutes, and then see if the paddle spins. In this one, the paddle doesn't spin at all, so I'm going to open it up and look inside what's wrong with it. And to open it up, there are no screws in the bottom. There are feet, but the rubber feet have no screws underneath. And the only screws are at the top. So I think these two have to be removed, and this has to be popped open, and the screws around the edge have to be removed. So I'm going to do that. I'm going to link below the history of bread machines. They started the one-stop, the ones that you put ingredients and take ready loaf of bread. They were first built in Japan by Matsushita, today Panasonic, back in the 1980s. And then by 1990s, every fifth American household had a bread maker at home. And then they gradually disappeared. Now they have a slow comeback, but because of that, you might be lucky to find a bread maker for cheap at a thrift store or garage sale or such. There are a few things I like about it. First is the price, $2.50 can be beat. Now it's a very simple operation. It has only a few options, but they are sufficient for my needs. The lid can be removed, which is very nice for cleaning. You can simply detach the lid, clean it up if the window gets dirty, and also have very easy access to the inside. When opening the bread maker, you'll find that some of the screws are stainless steel and some are regular steel. And these four screws are regular steel, and the remaining around here will be stainless, and also the three in the bottom are stainless. Now, you don't have to unscrew the side ones here, right here, and there is another one on this side, so you don't have to remove these. And also, you don't have to remove the ones that hold the cable winding holder. So these stay in place, you don't touch them, but you have to remove these around here, and they are stainless, they are not magnetic. These are regular steel, the four. These are magnetic screws, so you can use a magnetic screwdriver. Now these two are kind of security screws. You can see this is what they look like, so you have to have a screwdriver with a cut in the center. You can make one. You can take a screwdriver bit and cut it with a angle grinder or Dremel, and this will be just fine. These are also stainless, and they go right here. They hold the control panel. They are the ones that hold it in place. Now, there are plastic latches here, and two of them are on the side here, and they're kind of hard to break away, but you have to use force. And also there are front latches, and they are fine. Once you remove these screws, you have to pry the side or just force it up. If it breaks off, it doesn't really matter, because that's still going to be held together with the front latches and the two screws. The bread maker has three loads for the electricity supplied, and one of them is the motor, the kneading motor, and the other one is the heating element inside, right here, inside. And of course, there's a negligible tiny receiver of electricity, that's the brains of the operation. And we can take a look at the other side. This is a very simple power supply with 10 resistors and a capacitor in series. And we have a triac, and this is an old school NEC type, which is bad. And there is a relay. The relay turns on and off the heating element, and the triac is controlling the work of this motor, the kneading motor. Now, I have hooked up here this kilowatt type of a contraption just to demonstrate how much power each of these elements, especially the big ones, the motor and the heater, takes during the operation. I'm going to turn on the motor, and it's run through this kilowatt contraption. So this will show us how many watts. Say 65 watts. 65 watts is the power consumption of the motor, and we can check other functions. We can check the volts, we have 60 hertz, we can check the power factor, which is 0.93, which is pretty good. We have half amp, and this is the motor alone, without any load, without any dome. So I'm going to turn it off now, and we are going to do the same, checking the heating element. We'll see how many watts. So we have 65 watts for the motor. This is negligible. It's probably about 2-3 watts, the whole thing. I'm not going to even test it. Now we have connected the heating element, and we are going to turn it on and see how many watts does the heating element take. So it takes a moment for the kilowatt contraption to show. So we have 560 watts for the heating. And this is the label. It says 600 watts, 120 volts. This is the label in the bottom of the bread maker. Now, the Matsushita relay is rated at 10 amps, 24 volts, so this should easily handle the heater, which is 600 watts, so it's about 5 amps, less than 5 amps. But the triac right here, that thing, that's an old school NEC, and you can read the model number, that's AC03D, and that's quite popular triac from back in the day. And this one is rated only 3 amps and 400 volts. I'm going to replace it with this track I had around, lying around. I'm going to lay it right here so you can read the numbers, and that is the BT 138X600E. And this triac is 16 amps and 600 volts. The gate is sensitive, so it's 5 milliamp, the trigger, and this was 15 milliamps. However, I think they will be perfect as direct replacement. The pins are the same. So if you have this kind of device with this track, the NEC AC03D track, I think you can substitute it for something like this. And these are inexpensive. You can buy 20 of them for about $5 on eBay if you look for cheap price. Now I removed the old track, the NEC, and replaced it with the new one right here. So now what I'm going to do is hook up the cables and make just a quick test, see if the motor is the induction scroll cage motor, 120 volts, and we measure it with 65 watts, if that is going to operate with this new triac. I did mark all the cables, so this is four spots with a Sharpie before pulling them out. There's a single spot right here. And I also took pictures where they belong, so that way I have no doubt that the connection is correct. Everything about this bread maker is good quality. The microprocessor is made in Japan, and I just took it out so I can control, check some of the voltages and see the parts. The membrane switches should be fine. They should last for a long time. So I'm going to test it out now. I just wanted to show you how things are set up in the bread maker. The belt here is brand new. The only problem with it is that if you ever need to replace it, you have to dig it out of the enclosure. You cannot open the bottom. You have to see the screws are from the inside, this particular bread maker. The other ones made now, they are much easier with the access to the belt. But this is the old school. However, the machine is really nicely made. I'm very impressed with it. So I'm going to test it out now. I just turn on the cycle. So this will, in 15 minutes, it should begin to mix the dough. So I'll see what happens with the motor. In 15 minutes, it should start cycling the motor. So we'll check it out. And right now, it's heating up. I can hear the relay clicking on and off and heating up the chamber. So we'll see what happens. The clock now shows 3:36 at 3:35. The motor should start its operation and it will be kneading the dough. So we'll see what happens. We wait for the time, a few more seconds, and it will be 3:35 when the motor starts running. Here it is. So this is good news. I just turn off the machine so it doesn't make the noise. Everything will be put back together and the machine will be put in use. And if you like the video, give it a thumbs up. Thank you for watching.